Hey y'all, it's Little Rosie's turn. Welcome back to my channel. For this video, I'm doing my full coverage flawless foundation routine. So to start off, I'm going to prime and moisturize my face at the same time using some coconut oil from Now that I got on Amazon. And then next, I'm going to counteract some of the dark colors on my face using some red lipstick. So I'm basically just color correcting with a red to combat the browns and the purples that I have going on in my skin tone. So using a complementary color to the color that you have on your skin is what will mute it out. So that's why I'm using the red lipstick as a way to color correct those dark spots. And then I'm just going to blend it all out with my little tiny beauty blender. Color correcting is really important for me because you can't see any of the dark spots or dark circles when you put on the rest of the face, you know, the concealer and everything. So color correcting is super important for a full coverage foundation routine. And then next I'm going to use this cream foundation from Black Opal and Truly Topaz. It was a bit darker for my skin, but that's okay because the rest of my body was pretty tan. My face and my neck is a lot lighter than the rest of my skin. So it matches, don't worry. I don't have like a different color face than my body. And I really, really like the consistency of this foundation. I just got it. It's my first time using Black Opal products. And I have to say I'm pretty impressed with the finish and the consistency of it. And then to go on top of the cream foundation, I'm going to use the same color but in the liquid form from Black Opal. And I wanted to have, since it is full coverage, I wanted to build up the foundation, and I wanted to make sure that everything on my face was covered, which is also why I'm using a smaller foundation brush so that I can really get into my skin and I can focus in on every part of my face and make sure everything looks airbrushed and completely flawless. And then to soak up some of that product because I had a little bit too much, I'm taking a damp beauty blender and dabbing my face. And then for highlighting, I'm using the Honey Concealer from Black Opal. And I really, really like how it looked on my skin. It was only about a shade lighter than my skin tone, so it didn't look too light. And it wasn't too dark, so I was really, really pleased with the color. But I did find that it was a little bit too dark and I wanted a little bit more lift, especially underneath my eyes, because that is where I tend to be darker. So I decided to add some of my Maybelline Fit Me concealer on top of it to kind of lighten it up. And then I just blend everything out, make sure there are no streaks from the brush, and make sure that the products blend nicely into my skin and the foundation. And for contour, I'm using my Coconut Stick Foundation from Maybelline. It's a cream foundation, and I really like to use this to contour as a base before my powder contour because I find that it really helps the powder contour stick. And it makes it a little bit more dramatic and a little bit more defined than if I were just to use powder by itself. And creams on my skin work really, really well because my skin is a little bit drier. So if your skin is a little bit more oily, you may not want to use as much cream as I did. And then to set my face, I'm using the medium finishing powder from Black Opal. And that's just to get rid of some of the shininess and the wetness kind of look. I don't want to look oily. And to set my under eyes and bake, I'm using my translucent medium powder from CoverGirl. And it's also going to lighten up those under eye areas and the high points of my face because the powder is lighter. So that's why I use a translucent powder as opposed to like a banana powder, because I want to bring some of that lightness back, especially because the foundation was a little bit darker than I'm used to. And then I just brush everything away once it's set in. And onto contour, I'm using the Rich Mahogany shade from Black Opal, and it was a bit bit dark, as you can see. I was a little bit surprised by how dark it was and how pigmented, because I was not expecting that, which is, it's a good thing though. So I just kind of brushed it away and blended it in with my foundation, with my powder foundation brush again. And then I just contour the rest of my face, my nose, my forehead, my chin. So if you do your contour a little bit too harsh at first, fret not, because you can always blend it out with some more foundation. And for blush and bronzer, I'm using the To Reflect palette from Wet n Wild. And for my highlight, I'm using the Lumi Golden Liquid Glow from L'Oreal, which I love. However, the only issue is, because it's a liquid highlighter, it was a little bit hard to blend into my skin because of all the powder that was already in my face. So I would not suggest putting the liquid gold on top of your powder. Probably underneath it would have been a better choice. And then to finish it, I just spray my face with the NYX setting spray. And that is the completed look. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. And don't forget to subscribe and like this video. Bye!